I think we're going straight in the question to the head coach.
Coach, thank you so much for the time and the energy I saw you out there. Coach, you seem to have a little bit of a concern because you went maybe a little extra trying to look at the players. Was it a little decision time that you needed more before you landed upon your final squad?
I wouldn't say so. I had a clear idea what was going to be the squad selection. What I was trying to emphasize to the boys is for the boys who are not traveling, we have the Panama game coming up on the 17th, which is mainly going to be the local players. So we need to continue the preparation. So we try to kill three birds with one stone. That was the idea, all the preparation. So today was just because tomorrow I'm going to give them a recovery day. We had an extended session. That's why I try to get them in big spaces because that's what we're going to face coming up in the next couple of days. So the squad was more selected. I would probably say last night I was clear on it.
They seem to be quite a happy bunch, an enthusiastic bunch. And how did they receive what you had to put out to them?
Yeah, obviously, the ones who are not traveling, they're disappointed. And I expect them to be disappointed because you don't want to be left out of any squad. But now it's how they react from this disappointment to ensure that for the next squad, that they are in the next squad. So, but they were all in very good spirits. You see the competitiveness behind them, which I'm trying to get them to understand that every game counts, every training session counts, and they put it out today. Sometimes I need to control them because they want to do that well. The tackles will be a bit strong, but that's fine. That's fine. These are men.
What about the guys that you brought in from the secondary schools? What were your thoughts on their integration into the team?
Yeah, I think, well, I brought Judah in the end. Papi was a bit unlucky. I think Papi only completed two training sessions because he picked up a groin injury. So unfortunately for him, but with little Quinny, Judah, they were very good in the group. They integrated well. And I'm actually looking forward to have them being part of the Panama game. I think this one might be a bit too soon for them, but it was good to have them around the group so they can get an understanding what it's going to take. The speed of the game, the thought process. So I'm looking forward to coming back and starting to work with them when we get back in preparation for the Panama game because 9 out of 10 they're going to be involved in that.
And how the absence of Marigo hampered your plans this year?
It was a big blow for me. First and foremost, I'm sorry for the boy because for the time I've been working with him, he's been first class. He's always given me everything that I've asked for. He's played a key role for us in the games in the past, scoring the win against Panama, scoring in Costa Rica, equalizing against Grenada. So he plays a massive role for me. But as I said, in football, it's an opportunity for somebody else now. So somebody needs to come in and say, right, I'm going to make this position mine. And that's the idea because that's what football and that's what team sports is all about. So I hope he has a really, really quick and healthy and speedy recovery. We will miss him, but we continue to work on.
Yeah, some of the guys from the last MLS season without clubs now, a lot of them have found clubs. How important is that for you in terms of your plans going forward?
It's good if they go out there and they're playing. It's good for them personally on a financial level. I think that's been one of the, I want to say the positives, but it's also been a bit of a problem for me because every time I've selected a squad, I think I selected the squad today and tomorrow, three of them be turned foreign-based players, which is great for them and I'm happy. But I'm glad for them and it will always help. As I said before, if you can go and play in another country, which the league is consistent and the standard is higher, it helps the Trinidad and Tobago national team. So it's a positive. I think in general, if you look back, especially against the USA, I think, you know, Kalim did a very good job in that aspect, trying to get forward a bit more to creative. We need to get the wingers involved a little bit more. So we're going to try and rely on movement and in terms of that instead of one particular player because we can't afford to just rely on that. So I think we got the quality in the squad and we're going to try and utilize it.
World Cup campaign, qualifying campaign, the two major areas that you saw as sore points. Defensively, you know, giving up easy goals and also when you're attacking to not converting chances. So what we'll be looking at for these two friendlies specifically in
First and foremost is we're looking for improvement from that point because why? That is where the work needed to be done. Hopefully we're going to be playing the games. The idea is to keep clean sheets because if you keep a clean sheet, you go in with what you're coming back out with what you came with. So we're going to try and make sure that we can try and be solid defensively and organized. And then in the front line, it's just a shame that Chandon couldn't make it because obviously he's just signed for the club in Azerbaijan. I think it was important that we give them time to go in and settle because we need them to be comfortable in the environment there. But we're going to try and utilize the boys and them who are coming in. We've got the 9 foreign players to come in and join the group of locals. So we're going to try and make it work.
Based on the neutral format that has been implemented in CONCACAF, the home nations, Trinidad and Tobago has automatically qualified for the Gold Cup. Is your mind looking ahead to that and or is your preparation going to be based on looking ahead to that tournament?
Yeah, all the preparations now are geared towards going to this Gold Cup. All the preparations are geared towards being much better organized and much better competitive to qualify for Qatar 2022. So the process is where we are at now. We're going up the ladder. Once we get to the Gold Cup, by then we should have already played some of the more illustrious countries what people have been asking for, but I feel this is the right spot for us now. So the process continues. This is the next step in the process. We're going to take it from there after. But everything leads towards the preparation, towards the Gold Cup as we stand.
All right, now you wind it down.
What are the foreign based players? When are you expecting them to come in? Sunday, Monday?
I think they're all going to be here on Monday. Maybe one is Kalim is here already. And then we all travel on Tuesday together.
Okay, the commissioner.
So yeah, they're all going to be here and then we're all going to travel to Guadeloupe together. We're going to have two training sessions out there. So because it's important, even though they might come in with all, we need to make sure that the unity is there. We need to make sure everybody understand the rule and function. And then we're going to go into the two games from there.
Thank you so much,
Rich. Rian has done well. He's showed a good attitude. And sometimes things work in people's favor because, you know, it would have been a tight one between him and Keaton, but Keaton then had the opportunity to go to Czech Republic, which for whatever reason didn't come off. So Scott's selection was based around that. But hopefully Rian would come in and he would add something to the group. He's a quick, enthusiastic player. He did well in the last couple of games to Defence Force in the Pro League. So hopefully he'll be looking forward to it and he'll get his opportunity.
All right, thanks a lot. Okay.